Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to PhysVis. I'm Manish Sharma, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create a Quantum ESPRESSO input file from a WASP POSCAR file or a crystallographic information file, which is also known as a CIF file, or an extended XYZ file. And to do that, we'll be using a web app that I've created. So just go ahead and Google and type in CrysX file converter, and then go to the first link that you can see. So it is CrysX-file-converter.streamlit.app. Just go ahead and click on it, and you will see this, this user interface, which kind of looks like a Google Translate interface. So essentially, you can specify the input format, and then the output file format, and interconvert between these two. So it's like a Google Translate for chemical file formats. If you find this useful, you can cite it in your papers as well. So yeah, so as I said, so I have the crystallographic information file as well as the WASP POSCAR file for the graphene monolayer. So let's try to convert those to the Quantum ESPRESSO input file. So here we will select the input format to, let's say, WASP. And don't worry about this error. This is because now I have selected WASP and the default input contents are of an XYZ file. So let's go ahead and browse the computer to upload the WASP POSCAR for the graphene monolayer. And here it is. So here is the graphene's WASP POSCAR that you can see on the left. So it has 50 atoms. And on the right, now we will select the ESPRESSO input, that is Quantum ESPRESSO input. And here you will see that. So essentially you will get the cell parameters card as well as the atomic positions here in angstroms that you can then utilize for your Quantum ESPRESSO calculation. You cannot really use this as it is because you will of course need to provide some pseudo potential. So as you can see right now, it just assigns a dummy pseudo potential, but you will need to assign a proper pseudo potential name and then also its location here through the pseudo there. Keyword. And same thing can be done for a crystallographic information file. So just select the input format to be CIF and then browse and upload the CIF file. So here you can see how does the CIF look for this, and here is the Quantum ESPRESSO input file. And also I forgot to mention, you can also like get a nice visualization of these different file formats through this web app. You can also see the parsed lattice parameters, lattice vectors, atomic coordinates in Cartesian or fractional coordinates. So it's a really nice web app and very good to have it for interconverting between various file formats, especially between WASP and Quantum ESPRESSO and so on. Additionally, you can also convert the extended XYZ format. So it's here, so extended XYZ. So it is a format that is quite similar to the XYZ file format, except that as you will see here in the comment section. So yeah, so in the comment section, so the second line is the comment section. There you can give a plethora of details. So for example, you can give the lattice parameters and then properties about the different species and so on. And then you will have your regular atomic coordinates. And then again, it has converted those to the Quantum ESPRESSO input file. So yeah, so I think that is it for this tutorial. I hope you guys find this web app as well as this tutorial useful. In case you did, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave them in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day.